have here two classic Nokia phones from 1998. First, the 6110, followed a few months later by the 5110. These two models really helped drive Nokia's success in the late 90s. These are also the first ever phones to use the ARM processor, a CPU architecture that now powers over 90% of all phones in use today. These are also the first phones to include the popular Snake game. Nokia was adding lots of new abilities to their phones, including, amusingly, their first clock. This is the first Nokia to include a clock and an alarm, and with the 6110, also a calendar. The capabilities of this new hardware would continue to be developed by Nokia, but would also attract the interest of people who wanted to enhance and modify their own phones. Modifying phones is very popular today. If you look at the XDA developer forums or the iPhone jailbreak communities, you find a very large and active scene of people modifying their phones. A lot of people customize their phones by adding patches and tweaks to the operating system, well beyond the manufacturer's original design. Back in the early 2000s, there was a Nokia modding scene as well, starting with things like Logo Manager, Windows software which could create and upload simple graphics. You could replace the network name on the main screen with a graphic of your own choosing. Over time, Nokia modding continued all the way into the firmware, which allowed for the possibility of changing just about any aspect of the phone. One of the best forums for this was NokiaFree, or Nokia Flash Reverse Electronic Engineering, which had an active and very dedicated modding community. The most popular phone for modding at the time was the Nokia 3310. The 3310 was one of Nokia's third generation digital phones, otherwise known as DCT-3, of which the earlier 6110 and 5110 are the first of that generation. I'm going to take this phone modding all the way back to 1998 and see what it's like to mod on a vintage Nokia with an 84 by 48 pixel display. On the Nokia Free forums, probably the most well-developed tool is NokiX by Yak, with many others in the community also contributing to its development. Okay, I'm running NokiX. I'm now going to patch some Nokia firmware. So first I'll load up a 5110 firmware and specify an output file, which includes games, and now I can add patches, which come in the form of scripts. So if I load up some games, I can start adding them into the firmware. So there's some there, and these usually come with documentation. There we go. There's a good amount of information that comes with each game. That looks pretty good. Okay, so to add that to the game, I can now run the script compiler. So this is now adding all the patches into the firmware, and it will save the output file ready for flashing. Okay, it's time to flash firmware onto these Nokias. I've been looking forward to doing this for quite a while. The software I'll be using runs best on Windows 98, so I'll be using my Toshiba Windows 98 laptop to do this. The other thing I also need is a proper serial and parallel port. I do have a Dell desktop with proper serial and parallel, but it's always inconvenient to get that thing out. I recently found on Gumtree for $25 a Toshiba port replicator, which has serial and parallel. It's also got VGA out. There's a DC input. Okay, I'll start Windows 98. And one of the other things I have is a Nokia serial cable, so I can plug that straight into the serial port. And the other end will connect to these models of Nokia. Okay, with the Nokia powered up, I should be able to run NokTool. Okay, the phone is on and connected. So if I do read phone info, yeah, that works fine. This software is pretty good for unlocking the phone and activating net monitor and some of the other hidden functions inside the phone. I can read the RAM and the EEPROM and even write to it as well. One thing this software can't do is flash firmware. and that's because Nokias have two serial ports on them. One is a two-wire fast port called F-bus, and the other is the M-bus, which is a single-wire bi-directional port, which is mostly used for servicing the phone. It seems that the flashing procedure needs to talk to the M-bus and the F-bus at the same time. So this serial cable is not going to work. Instead, I'm going to have to use the parallel port. I'm going to have to build a cable from the parallel port, and I also have a connector for this model of Nokia. So I'm going to get on with building a flashing cable and seeing if I can flash some firmware into these Nokias. There are circuit diagrams online showing how to do it, and I found this very simple circuit which I'm going to build now. I've gathered all the components together to do the build, and the chip that's used in this circuit is a hex converter. Though the main function that this chip will be used for is to convert the voltage, because parallel ports run at 5 volts and Nokias use 2.7 or 2.8 volts. So if you power this chip at 2.8 volts, it will convert the signal and connect to the Nokia. So the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to invert this chip and glue it into the shell. There's the indentation telling me where pin 1 is, and I'm going to glue that. I'll get some hot glue into the shell. Okay, get some wires onto the parallel port. Okay, I've got a resistor and a capacitor across the power pins on the chip to help control the power. So that's ground, which I need to connect up here. And green to pin 2. Alright, that looks pretty good. Now this chip needs to be connected to power, so the way that that's going to happen is two diodes are going to go from two of the spare data lines and connect up to the voltage input. Now I've got to get the Nokia connector. Okay, four wires, ground, M-bus and two F-bus. Hopefully that's going to be strong enough. I really should put some strain relief in there, but for now I just want to test it and see if it works. White goes to pin 2 on the IC. Okay, there we go. That should be all the wiring that's needed. And I'll better go through and double check everything and also make sure that nothing is shorting out. Last thing I want to do is harm my new parallel port or even the Nokias that I'm going to be connecting to. It's a bit of a rat's nest, but that should do the job. Okay, I'm going to give this a try and see what happens. So I'm just going to plug this in and hopefully nothing blows up. Right. Now we've got a phone. Alright, everything's connected. There's the flashing software. And the first function I'm going to try is to read the firmware out of this phone. Read. Press power on. Ooh, so we've got an error. Well, it did detect something, but it hasn't worked. Hang on. It doesn't even have the right sort of phone selected. This is a Nokia 5110. Okay, start again. Flash, read, and power. Nope, that's not it. I'll try the 6110 instead. See if that makes a difference. select 6110, flash read. Oh, that seems to have worked, and it's reading the flash. I wonder why the 5110 didn't work. Right, I'm going to have another look at the 5110, see if I can work out what's going on. Connection seems fine. Let's try that flash read again. Oh, okay. So now it's working. I think it was probably just a bit of dirt on the bottom connector and it wasn't quite connecting correctly. Okay, it looked like the readout went okay, so that's the 5110, software 420. Alright, I'm just going to flash some custom firmware directly into this phone now. I'm going to write, and I'm going to choose 5110 with games. Okay, write that in, and power on. Okay, it's erasing the flash. And it's now writing. Okay, it's written the flash into the phone. This is pretty exciting. Let's see if it's worked. Turning on. Oh yeah, I need a SIM card. All right, let's have a look. Menu. Now this is the flash that's got games in it. So let's go have games. Memory Snake Logic. Oh, look, there they are. That is awesome. It's now filled with games. Let's have a look at Maze. 3D Maze by Yak. That is so awesome. Oh, that is so cool. All right, I'm going to set this up and have a look through the software that's in here now. All right, let's have a look at some of the new games that have been added to this 5110 and see what they're like. So the first three are the standard Nokia games, and now we've got Balloons by Norrin. Quite a nice title screen. Instructions. 1, 2, 3, 4. Shoot down a sight. Shoot down, use key 5. Thanks, Norrin. New game. So, okay. Oh, yeah. Not a bad little game. Bit of pipe. Build a solid pipe. 5 to rotate. So this game's all right. It's reminds me of another game, but I can't remember what it's called. Next game, Breaker. Oh, that looks like it's going to be an Arkanoid clone. There, we've got sound. Yak. Oh. This is awesome. This is very responsive. All right, that one looks awesome. Maze 3D. This is the one that I saw when I first flashed it. Perhaps not the greatest game, but it is pretty cool looking, and it really is a maze. It's more like an awesome tech demo. I guess I'll have a look at the map, see what that looks like. Hey, there's that map. Oh, there we go. Minesweeper by Druid Bartek. Okay, well, this seems like a fairly familiar game. There we go. Hey, what happened? I think it crashed. Stones. Okay, a yak game. Let's just go straight into the game. Alright, well, it looks like... It looks like this game could be something like Go, perhaps? Just have a quick look at the instructions. Alright, so it's not Go, but it's a similar sort of thing. As well as games, there are applications, patches, and tweaks. I just found another awesome game called Bomberman. NokiX also includes a well-documented SDK, so you can create your own apps to run on these Nokias. The whole project is open source, with enough documentation to get started. I still have much more to look through, and I need to finish my parallel flashing cable. I would like to add the option of interchangeable connectors for different Nokia models. I'm also really pleased with my new port expander. Having easy access to a serial and parallel port on a small DOS machine is really useful. Let me know you enjoyed this with a thumbs up. I'm always interested in any comments, and thanks for watching.